أفلح من صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Today I'm going to be speaking about the Imams of the Baqir. There are four Imams of the Baqir. The first one is Imam Hassan al-Mushtaba alayhi salam, Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salam, and Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam. I will speak about each Imam briefly. And the first one I'm going to talk about is Imam Hassan alayhi salam. If you didn't know, Imam Hassan alayhi salam had amazing manners. He was one of the most merciful imams, to the point where if he'd see a poor person on the street or somebody without food, he would give them food, and sometimes he would take people off the street to his own house. So he would feed them and he would flip people's lives over. So like if you were poor and Imam Hassan alayhi salam saw you on the street, it's like a mustahil that he wouldn't pick you up and give you food and tell you, oh, come to my house so I can feed you and change your life. Imam Hassan alayhi salam was merciful to the point where he didn't even want to fight Muawiyah, the person that was doing bad during his time, the person that was mocking him, the person that was hurting him. He didn't even want to hurt him. That's how merciful he was. He was so merciful and so pure that Nabi Muhammad said that Imam Hassan alayhi salam and Imam Hussein alayhi salam are Sayyidah Shabab Ahl al-Jannah. What that means is like they're the men of Jannah. And Imam Hassan alayhi salam and Imam Hussein alayhi salam were both born on like the lap of Nabi Muhammad Muhammad. The next Imam I want to get into is Imam Zain al-Abidin. Imam Zain al-Abidin had amazing manners and he was extremely religious. He was religious to the point where one time he was praying and like the floor around him where he was praying caught fire. Everyone's reaction once they're praying and the floor around them catches fire is, let me get up off the floor so I don't damage myself. That wasn't the case. When Imam Zain al-Abidin was praying on the floor, the floor around caught fire and his friends were saying, oh, get up, what are you doing? Get up off the floor, don't damage yourself. Imam Zain al-Abidin continued praying, and once he continued praying and he finished, the fire on the floor like went out, and then his friends were like, oh, what were you doing on the floor? You could have damaged yourself. Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam said, when I was on the floor, I thought about the fire of the end, and then I quickly realized, why would I think about the fire of the end? It's not like I'm going there. And in Imam Zain al-Abidin's name, Imam Zain al-Abidin, that last part, al-Abidin, means like he's adoring, he adores people to Islam. It also means like, al-Abidin means he swallows his anger, because at the time of Imam Zain al-Abidin, there was people that would be mocking him, there's people that would be throwing rocks at him just to get into his head and get him mad. But Imam Zain al-Abidin wouldn't be giving into it. Like in today's society, if you get somebody mad, they're gonna give in and they're gonna try to get you mad. That wasn't the case. Imam Zain al-Abidin wouldn't be giving in to the people trying to get him mad. The next Imam I want to speak about is Imam Muhammad al-Baqir. Imam Muhammad al-Baqir was kind of like, he was a teacher. He spent his whole life teaching and making a lot of the hadiths a lot of you guys read today. He spent his whole life teaching the kids, the people around him, so they could be educated to the next generation, so they could keep passing on the education. Like he curated schools, he curated colleges for people. He even went out of his own way to create a hawza for Islamic studies. So like, let's say people, after they finish school in regular college, they wanted to take part in Islamic studies to learn about the Nabis before them, the four Immas before them, because this was at the time of Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, so it was only four Imams before him. So if they wanted to learn about them, they would go to the house and they would learn. And in Imam Muhammad al-Baqir's name, al-Baqir, it means like one who makes the knowledge, one who creates the knowledge. So like, it pretty much means that he creates hadiths. He created like hadiths that we have today. He gathered hadiths that we have today. And the next Imam I want to talk about is Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq. Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, from like all the amazing things he is, one thing is he's al-Sadiq, it's in his name, al-Sadiq. What that means is like he's trustful, he's merciful, he's beloved. And like somebody else who was given that title, al-Sadiq al-Amin, was Nabi Muhammad, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq wasn't only a Sadiq, like he used to, when people used to bash on Islam and talk bad about Islam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq would like clear up the fake stuff that they said, and he would turn it into good stuff, and he would back it up with evidence. Like if somebody said something bad about Islam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq would tell the people that that's a lie, and he would back it up with evidence so he could get more people onto the side of Islam. And he was probably, it was him and Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, one of the smartest imams. Like they spent a lot of their life teaching, a lot of their life learning. So those are about the four imams of al-Baqir. Aina nahnu min ha'ula al-a'imma al-lazi stushud min ajlina. The way these imams were backstabbed were, I'm going to talk about three ways. The first way is the way they were killed. The second way is where they were buried. And the third way is like how, for some of the imams, it's not for all the imams, how we can't go and visit their shrines. I'm gonna explain each one briefly. So the first one I wanna talk about is how they were killed. If you didn't know, almost every imam was killed by somebody, not a natural death, but they were killed. The first one I wanna talk about is Imam Ali alayhi salam. So Imam Ali alayhi salam was killed while he was praying in Masjid al-Kufa. And the reason that they killed him while he was praying in Masjid al-Kufa was because they knew that Imam Ali alayhi salam had khushu' in his prayer. Like once he was praying, he didn't care about the surroundings around him. It was his time with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if everybody knew that if they fought Imam Ali alayhi salam in one-on-one combat, that they wouldn't win. The second Imam I want to talk about is Imam Hassan alayhi salam. Imam Hassan alayhi salam was the same case as Imam Ali alayhi salam. He was extremely strong and nobody could beat him in one-on-one combat. So Muawiyah paid Imam Hassan alayhi salam's wife to poison his food and like so he could die. And it worked. She gave in to Muawiyah. And the third Imam I want to talk about is Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Imam Hussein alayhi salam was killed by Yazid. And by like Yazid's people, and they decapitated his body, which I don't know why they would do that, like they already killed him, I don't see why they would decapitate it. And the second one I want to talk about is where they were buried, and the third one is like why we can't visit. These ones go like together. So if you didn't know, Imam Hassan alayhi salam, Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salam, and Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, they're buried in the Baqir in Mecca, Saudi Arabia, right by the where Nabi Muhammad Muhammad's buried. But there, like where they're buried is not the same as Imam Ali alayhi salam, Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Like they don't got a shrine where you can go visit them. Like in the Baqir, there's people in Saudi Arabia that just guard it and they don't let you go in and go and visit their shrine, which I don't see why they do that, because like they don't really care about the imams. They're just trying to get in our head, oh, we can't go and visit four of our imams. It's like, it's kind of weird because they don't, we can go and visit Nabi Muhammad alongside Muhammad, but when we want to go and visit those four imams, they just make us stand around and then you could just look at them. So I don't see why they do that. Nas'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and yu'ajjal bifaraj Rabbi Imam Mahdi, and to get us our rights, like get us what was stolen from us, like, because they killed Imam Ali alayhi salam, they killed Imam Hassan alayhi salam, they killed Imam Hussein alayhi salam, they killed Fatima, Sayyidina Fatima alayhi salam, they took Sayyidina Fatima's land from her, Abu Bakr took Fadak from her. We want to get what was stolen from us. And akhir da'wan alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
أحسنت يا فرسول الله. أحسنت يا فرسول الله. أحسنت يا فرسول الله. هدوا البقيع وظنهم ننساها لم يعلموا أن بالقلوب هواها لم يعلموا أن المغيب سيدي سيعود يعطي للحياة ضياها